people get so angry when you don't see a thing the way they see a thing. And I still don't get that. I still don't understand why I have to believe it, or I have to see it, you know, see it or even receive it the way you, your mind processes.
The world can't stop talking about your love life, your marriage to your wife, Jessica.
Is that what they're talking about?
That's what they're talking about. And, and I know in a recent interview, you said, you know, there was not a need for you to come out. There was no closet for you to come out of. And you just, you chosen to love yourself and love your partner, your wife, authentically. And it's been such an inspiration, I believe, to a lot of people. How does it feel to have such an embrace from the community and people seeing you as an inspiration?
Well, let me say, you know, I am so grateful for the people who have gathered around Jessica and I. Now, Jessica was not new to the community, huh? She's probably a founding member. However, I just got here. Oh, boy. And it is so great to be received, to be loved on. And that love has outshone any negativity that would have shown up in our lives. But with or without the negativity, I'm so freaking happy. And I'm not gonna give that up, you know? And so I'm happy if people can look at whatever we're over here doing, we just living. But if they could take anything from that or it's inspiring in any kind of way, then, you know, I'm grateful for that.
That's beautiful. I want to talk about young people as well, because celebrities and non-celebrities alike have had a lot of discussions, a lot of strong opinions, I should say, about young people who identify within the community, within the LGBTQ plus community, one of whom being Zaya Wade, the daughter of Dwayne Wade. And he recently, I guess, thanked the haters for saying what they said, because it's bringing attention to the community and these walks of life for young people who are choosing to own who they are. What are your thoughts about people outside the community having such opinions about things that are happening within the community, one, but then also, what are your thoughts generally about young people identifying as who they are much earlier than I think previous generations have?
The first part I'll say about that is, you know, I love when Dwayne said that, you know, it wasn't his responsibility basically to tell his child who she is. It's her responsibility to tell her parents who she is and then them to support her, you know, in that. And I feel like, you know, it's funny about opinions. People get so angry when you don't see a thing the way they see a thing. And I still don't get that. I still don't understand why I have to believe it or I have to see it, you know, see it or even receive it the way your mind processes it. You know, we're all individuals, you know what I mean? And it's always somebody talking about something from a standpoint that really doesn't even relate to them. You know what I mean? And so it's just kind of like, I get it. I get it. We all have opinions and everybody has a right to that. But people also have a right to just live their life. But and some people are so negative and so mean, you know, and you say, why would I ever want to listen to you? Why would you even think that that is the way to speak to somebody, to judge somebody, to be towards another individual? I don't like the ugly part of it, but I do appreciate what Dwayne said in that it is moving the conversation forward. You know, and that's the sweet spot in the darkness of that.